Hello students, how are you all? I hope all of you are fine and well. And welcome back to your next English class. This is Anupu ma'am. And I hope you are preparing yourself very well. And you all know the syllabus of your first unit test, as your unit test is just near. So we are giving you just a practice work and on the revision chapters. And from literature also I have given, and from grammar it is running. Last year also I have discussed about adjective, about pronoun. There were so many practice work. So today I have added some practice work from adjective for you. Okay, you can see fill in the blanks with adjective. It is written here. So there are so many practice work I have arranged for you. So today I am not giving you the answers. I will discuss the question and I am giving you the options. There are options, you can see. It is your duty to do it right now. Okay, it is your homework. You have to do it and send me into the comment box. You have to send me. Okay, so see, first question. Those are probably the dash curtains in the store. Now you have to choose the option fanciest, most fanciest, more fancier. Now you have to choose which should be the proper one. And last day I have told you, whenever you will put adjective, you have to see the degree of the sentence also. If the sentence is in positive sentence, you can understand there is no comparison. If that is comparative degree, then you can see this word you can see. So there is not than, but I told if you see the, this word you have to understand this is in superlative degree. Okay, so actually what is a fancy? This is fanciest spelling, fanciest. You can understand fanciest. So which should be the correct spelling? You should understand most fanciest. See, whenever you see that one word, that is automatically changeable to the comparative form or to the term, to superlative form. So they should not give most or more like this way. Okay, so what should be here, you have to understand. You have to select and then you have to send me into comment box. This homework is for you. You have to send me. Okay, next number. Number 2. Uncle Carl is really dash man. Uncle Carl is really dash man. An old switch, switch old or normally a. So you have to understand, you have to put adjective. Suitable adjective. Okay. So now it is your duty to put it from here. Next. The Karman here used to be dash sports car. A fine German, or a normal fine. You have to understand. Number 4. Everyone was home for the holidays. What could make for dash Christmas than that? Everyone was home for the holidays. Everyone was in home for the holidays. What could make for dash Christmas than that? You can see than, this word is there. So there are the options. A merrier, the merriest, a merrier, or a merry. Merry means happy. Okay, you have to understand this. What could make for dash Christmas than that? Okay, next question. They grew up in dash house in Mexico City. They grew up dash house in Mexico City. Options: a comfortable little, a little comma comfortable, a comfortable little. Number in number A there is a comma, number C there is no comma. A little. Now you have to understand, we should be here. Okay, they grew up in dash house in Mexico City. Okay, you have to put adjective. You have to understand. Next question. The eagle was dash than the bluebird. See here, the word than is there. I told you in the first, whenever you will put adjective, you have to remember, you have to notice that sentence is in positive degree or comparative degree or superlative degree. Positive degree means there is equality, there is no comparison between anyone. That one is bigger, one is lower. No, not like that. Comparative degree, the comparison between two people. One is bigger than other. Here comes than. In comparative degree, you can see the word than, D-H-A-N, than. So the eagle was big, bigger, biggest. Okay, you should know the word, the adjective. These are the adjective and these are the big is a positive form. Bigger is a comparative form. Biggest is a superlative form. I hope you know. It is just a revision part. So I just revised you. I just tell you for remembering. Okay. So which word should be here? The eagle was dash than the bluebird. Okay. So than means you can understand this should be it in comparative degree. Right. You can't make it in superlative degree. You should maintain it properly. Here you can see the difference between two sentences. Those are probably the. Here it is the. And here it is than. Than it should come after the adjective. And the it should come before the adjective. Okay. The adjective may be in superlative, the adjective may be in comparative, that is what I am telling. But in superlative degree, first the comes the, then you can see the adjective. But in comparative degree, first adjective comes, then this word comes. Okay, there is a little bit difference between two sentences. Okay. Next question. Choose the adjective in this sentence. There is a sentence. You should choose which one is adjective in this sentence. The boy wore a blue shirt to school. Okay, so now you know what is adjective. Adjective means a word which gives you the quality of a noun or pronoun. The quality that may be good quality, that may be bad quality, and it describes about the noun. Right, so you have to understand which one is adjective. How you can understand? See, that boy, it is noun. Here in this sentence, it is noun. It is a subject and it is noun, right? The boy is noun, or it is verb, because it gives you a action verb. It gives you an action verb, right? Next, the boy wore a blue shirt to school. This is total predicate, right? But a blue shirt, it is also another noun. It is also another noun, shirt. Shirt is also noun. Right? There are two nouns. A boy wore a blue shirt, shirt is noun. To school, this is object. Okay, where he is going, the boy is going to school. But here, extra word is there, a blue. Now, you say me, ma'am, so which parts of speech this? See, the blue, it is indicating the color of shirt. It is indicating the color of shirt. So it is indicating the quality of the shirt, the quality of the noun. If the shirt is also noun, this means it indicates the quality of the shirt, means the quality of the noun. That may be good quality, that may be bad quality, that may be anything else. But it is showing the, it is indicating the quality of this noun, this particular noun. So, a blue, this is adjective. Which word gives you the description about the quality of the noun? That is adjective. So by this way you have to understand in a sentence. Suppose you are getting this kind of word, sorry, this kind of sentence, you have to understand which word is adjective. So by this you will understand, I hope. Now it will not be any problem for you. And already you have given your exam and already you have got this kind of question in your exam paper, so it should not be any problem. But still, if you have to face any kind of problem, just prepare yourself again and again and just question yourself, okay? Then you will get the answer. Still, so what should be the answer? The boy or blue shirt, already I have told you, okay? So but otherwise, all the answers, I didn't tell you all the answers. You should do it and send it to me in the comment box. You have to do. You can pause your video and you can see these lines and you can write in your copy also. This is your practice work. You can practice it and you can practice this type of question in your home also. Okay, go to the next page. See, since it may rain, it is a dash idea to bring an umbrella. Since it may rain, again the question, that kind of question, fill in the blanks. Okay, since it may rain, it is a dash idea to bring an umbrella. So good or better or best or worst, now you have to do it. You can understand what kind of sentence this is. There is not than. So what kind of sentence is this? What kind of degree this is? You have to understand. Okay, so this is your homework. You have to do it and you have to send me within today. You have to send me in comment box. If you don't send me in within today, I don't take it. Suppose you are giving it tomorrow and the next day, but I on that moment I can't change it, I can't check it. Okay, you have some more practice work from adverb. I have joined with your class today. See the adverb. I hope you remember the adverb. What is adverb? Which word that modifies a verb? Suppose you are telling the horse is running first. The horse is running very fast. So you are modifying by the word very. How is the horse is running? Horse is running first. It is his quality, good quality. But you are modifying how much first? Very first. So one word very you are using to modify that adjective. So that is that. What is adverb? I hope you remember the definition of adverb. So choose the adverb. We rarely go to the movies on the weekends. The word rarely modifies adverb, verb or pronoun or adjective. Next, our house is practically, see there should be a box, you have to do it. Our house is practically on the highway. Which one is adverb? Highway, practically, house or is. Next, that's a lovely painting. The word lovely is adverb, adjective, verb or noun. You should have to do it. You have to understand it. Okay. You can pause the video and you can write down in your copy and you can do the answers. Okay. You have to send it today, by today. See. If you can't see the line, you can zoom your video, you can check it down. Right. You can pause your video and you have to do it and send me into the comment box. Okay, so this is one practice work for you from adjective. I hope you can do it very well. Okay, so please do it and send me into comment box. Okay, you can send only options number 1 A, number 2 B, number 3 C, like this way. Okay, so thank you so much. Keep watching my video. Have a nice day and wait for the next video. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.